Ekko at Home Edition. I'm Talia Schultz and today is Thursday, April 9th, 2020. Thanks for tuning us in. I hope you and your family are all safe and healthy. Needless to say, in the past 20 years that broadcast journalism students have been producing this show, we've never done it like this, where we're literally making stories from our own homes. To give you a sneak peek behind the scenes, in the last 7 days, we worked in teams to not only put this together, but also readjust ourselves to this new way of making the Ekko. We're using Zoom, and we're in the process of learning how to use Wii Video. So, if this show isn't quite up to the standard of past episodes, know we are working hard to figure this all out. Hopefully, we're going to continue to bring you first-class stories about the people and events that make up Hastings High School. To get started with today's show, you, like many people, may be looking for a way to keep your mind at ease during this quarantine madness. Ekko reporter Erin Lindstrom has come up with some simple activities to keep you busy and entertained. Here's her report.
Are you looking for something to do during quarantine? We'll look no further because here are some activities you can do from home. One thing that I've been doing a lot is baking, and recently I baked banana bread. All you need is a few basic ingredients along with some ripe bananas. Pretty soon you'll have wasted some time and you'll have delicious banana bread. Another thing that you can do is gardening. Gardening is a great activity for something that you can do either inside or outside. If you're looking for a less involved activity, video games might be your thing. Whether you're playing Fallout 4 like my sister, or the more recently popular Animal Crossing, it can take up most of your day. My favorite thing that I've been doing is this giant paint-by-number. It's very time-consuming, and it only cost me $15 on Amazon. Just be warned, it may take you a really long time to finish. If you're looking to spend some time outdoors, I would suggest going on a walk. You can go by yourself or take a pet with you. Either way, it's a good idea to step out of the house, even if it's only for 20 minutes.
One way me and my brother were passing time was by jumping on our trampoline.
Whether you're out on the trampoline like Brad or baking inside, make sure you're staying active and having fun. Reporting for the Ekko at Home, this is Erin Lindstrom.
That trampoline jumping got us thinking about sports. One of the many sports that have their regular season sideline is lacrosse. Ekko reporter Drew Gerlach gives us an inside look on what's happening with the girls' lacrosse team.
This season of spring sports is going to be a little different than the rest. Since the coronavirus outbreak, our teams are having to do things much different now. The girls' lacrosse team has extreme potential for their upcoming season.
Our girls are doing a fantastic job at staying connected through this hard time, and they're staying connected by doing.
Corwin has optional workouts that we've been posting for people, and then an optional Zoom meeting that we do, and it's actually been kind of neat. I really like it. It's every Monday at 3 o'clock.
Head coach Corwin Berg and assistant coach Andy Gerlach are helping as much as they can to keep the team together.
The workouts are optional. We don't have, the girls don't have to do them, but we thought it would be a good idea.
Many coaches from all spring sports are providing optional workouts for their teams.
This week's workout is going to start off with a warm-up, 3 rounds. I'm going to have Grace do a quick little demonstration, It's going to be 20 seconds.
Varsity assistant coach Andy posts Metcon type of workouts, and
Corwin posted running-based workouts.
The lacrosse team uses an app like many other teams.
You can chat, you can post pictures, you can do videos.
Andy has high hopes the girls are doing the workouts while still having fun.
On the band app is where we post the workouts, and when girls finish, they'll take a selfie of themselves all sweaty or just got done running, or they'll post their time.
The girls will even include others in their fun.
A lot of the lacrosse girls are bringing their siblings with them even, and they're like, I just ran 2 miles, cradling the whole way, and I brought my little sister with.
Staying happy, healthy, and connected during this time is essential for our athletes and students.
It's good to just see people still smiling, still staying positive.
Make sure yourself, you even get outside and enjoy this spring. Mr. Hansen, our high school athletic director, is just as bummed as our athletes. For now, all in-person practices and games for Hastings High School spring sports have been suspended until May 4th per the governor, Tim Walz. Mr. Hansen and our coaches hope to have a version of an in-person season in May, yet we will know more in April. Mr. Hansen does want to say how rewarding it is to see how focused our teams and coaches have been about staying connected with each other through these challenging times. And our girls lacrosse team is doing just that. Reporting for the Ekko, this is Drew Gerlach.
Who would have thought you can do spring sports over Zoom? I sure didn't. Coaches have made sure to keep their players in shape and ready for whenever the season finally rolls around. Experts say that music can bring peace in times of chaos. One student has taken this quite seriously. The Ekko's Caitlin Christian brings us down a musical path that could bring us all together.
Music is a great way to relieve stress. So during this uncertain time, Mason strums away. This passion started before social distancing.
Maybe over a year now.
As a gift.
I got my guitar on my birthday.
And this passion has no limits.
I can play a decent amount of songs.
But each day is a learning experience.
I'm still trying to figure out bar chords and stuff.
The past year, Mason has been working hard.
I started out using an app called Musician.
But the app is not his only big help.
I went to my sister's husband, which is now my brother-in-law.
A family affair.
And he taught me most of the stuff I know.
They even jammed together. Eventually, he had to learn on his own.
Learned off of looking at chords and figuring out finger placement and strumming patterns.
Mason does put his music out there.
My main account now on Instagram to post things if I'm feeling like up to it.
Mason is even hosting a show.
Talent show is this thing that I'm hosting.
This week.
Just this nice way to get everyone involved.
Hoping to have more than his friend group participate.
Be a bunch of people that don't really know each other, but we'll be able to get to learn something new about each other.
Hoping to build some new friendships.
Posting that on April 11th.
If you're not busy, reach out to perform or watch. So during this quarantine,
I've kind of enjoyed my guitar a lot more than what I do when school is going.
It keeps Mason busy.
And I enjoy doing it.
Reporting for the Ekko, I'm Caitlin.
As you just heard, Mason's talent show starts at noon this Saturday, April 11th on Zoom. Hope to see all of you there showcasing your musical talents. During this quarantine, I'm sure one hobby we all have in common is eating. Ekko's Faith Forstad takes us into her kitchen to show us a goodie you'll all want to gobble up.
Hey guys, it's Faith Forstad, and I hope that you guys are all safe and healthy and doing well at home. Something that I've been doing over quarantine to keep myself busy is baking, doing lots of cooking and being creative in the kitchen. And today I'm going to show you guys how to make one of my favorite recipes, lunch lady brownies. So let's get to it.
So to make the brownies, the ingredients you're going to need are flour, granulated sugar, eggs, 2 sticks of butter, vanilla extract, and sweet ground cocoa, or unsweetened cocoa powder works too. To start, you're going to want to preheat your oven to 350 degrees. Next, you're going to want to get a 13 by 9 pan and line it with aluminum foil. Then, you're going to want to spray the pan with non-stick spray. Next, you're going to mix your 2 sticks of butter with your 1/2 cup of unsweetened cocoa powder, or if you have sweet ground cocoa like me, you're going to want to put 1 cup of it in. Blend the butter and the cocoa powder together until it's smooth. Once the butter and the cocoa powder is mixed together smooth, you're going to add 2 cups of flour and 2 cups of sugar if you used unsweetened cocoa powder, or 1.5 cups if you used sweet ground cocoa. Mix these ingredients until they are mixed together. After the cocoa powder, butter, sugar, flour are all mixed, add 4 eggs and 4 teaspoons of the vanilla extract, and then mix until they are mixed, but make sure that you don't overmix. The batter is supposed to be very thick, so make sure you don't overmix while combining the ingredients. Next, pop those bad boys into the oven for 25 to 30 minutes. In a mixing bowl, add 1/2 stick of butter, 1/4 cup of unsweetened cocoa powder or 1/2 cup of sweet ground cocoa, and 3 cups of powdered sugar. Mix the ingredients together until they're well blended at a frosting consistency. Ba-bam! Perfect frosting. Let the brownies cool for about 15 minutes before frosting them. However, you still want the brownies to be a little bit warm while you're frosting them. Brownies have cooled for about 15 minutes. It's time to frost them. The brownies are supposed to still be a little bit warm while you're frosting them. After frosting, let the brownies sit for another 15 minutes before serving. Once your brownies are completely cooled, you can cut them and enjoy.
All right, and once you cut up and serve the brownies, here's the best part, the taste test. Mm-hmm.
If you want to try Faith's brownies at home, make sure you snap her pictures of your final results. After those brownies, I need to know how to stay in shape. Fortunately, the Ekko's Colby Zach has been on Hastings' infamous trails to give us some workout motivation.
Exercise. It's something many of us may have taken for granted before the pandemic.
Not everybody has a lot of access to a lot of equipment, especially at their homes. We're all kind of quarantined inside.
Now that all the gyms in town are closed, people must find alternate ways to stay in shape.
So the biggest thing is trying to find activities that everybody can do.
Mr. Hanneberg knows a thing or two about exercising, as he teaches Spark, Lift, Human Performance, and is even our school's head wrestling coach.
What we're doing for the HP department is every class period, providing them with the workout that they should be doing. You don't need a lot of equipment at a gym, or you don't need a gym membership to kind of stay active and fit. It doesn't take a lot of skill or equipment to do push-ups and squats and things like that around your house. Things don't take a lot of weight to use, so we can use soup cans. We can find different things to do pull-ups on. We do dips in different ways. So just trying to find things that everybody can do at their house.
Mr. Hanneberg encourages people to get outside in any way they can.
A lot of people are outside running or biking or rollerblading. We have some beautiful trails right here in town. Putting on some rollerblades and going rolling around town is awesome.
Fortunately for us, as members of the Hastings community, we have access to countless gorgeous trails dispersed throughout the city.
Our trails are beautiful, and I really appreciate our community investing in something like that. A lot of the trails over by Vets, too, take you through some beautiful areas around town.
Whether you have a set distance you want to travel, or you prefer to be more spontaneous with your workouts, the Hastings Trail System is perfect for anyone looking to get their fix of cardio.
Trails connect all over the place, too, so you can start in one part of town and go to the other.
If you're still confused about what to do, don't be afraid to reach out to the internet and look for some workout advice.
If you don't know what to do, just Google home bodyweight workouts and then see what kind of pops up from there.
No matter what you decide to do, stay safe, keep your social distance.
This is Colby Zach reporting for The Ekko.
All that running has me winded. As Mr. Hanneberg said, make sure you're staying active and try to get out as much as possible. But stay safe and keep washing your hands. Hey, that wraps up our very first at-home edition. How many more of these types of episodes are we going to have? Well, at the moment, we're planning on continuing to get out a new show for you every week until this COVID-19 lockdown is over. But let's hope we'll be able to reunite back at good old AJ Jazz at some point next month. Until we meet again, I'm Talia Schultz, and this is The Ekko.
I've been trying to call. I've been on my own for long enough. Maybe you can show me how to love. Maybe I'm going through a drought. You don't even have to do too much. You can turn me on with just a touch.